What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to EU4 with the War of the Spanish Secession scenario. We actually had an even bigger secession war coming up. The Commonwealth is now part of Russia. I don't know how that all went down, but it seems so weird. Russia lost, but not obviously enough for the Commonwealth to be freed or given to somebody else. So that was a bit of a weird scenario. But there we go. Russia does now have them as a vassal, and they then allied France. So they are going to be quite an interesting player in the rest of the game. Obviously, they're caught in a weird place. They're going to be very strong in Europe, but, you know, if Qing keeps attacking them, it could get a bit scary. But I think that was just a great power war. I don't think we'll see it happen again. I think that's the only reason Qing was even involved, was through the great power sort of thing. And there's going to be a peace treaty now for a while. So, yeah, they probably should be safe. Qing is fighting a war over this way. Wait, are these guys in? I have no idea. What is this? Is like a mix of way too many lines and colors. It's yellow on purple. Very weird effect. No, they are not involved. These guys are involved. A lot of their stuff is wasteland, and yeah, some of these guys. So it should be a pretty emphatic victory again for Qing and their allies. Don't see them losing that one. Bashkirian separatists, Qazim separatists, Eretnid separatists. I'm sure Russia can handle this, but we'll keep an eye out. You never know. Things can get out of hand pretty quickly sometimes. Prussia is once again struggling in West Africa. I think there's a point where you just give up. Like, it's not working for you. Just give up. I'm not sure that is the best plan for you. Oh, wow. There is not many natives left. Who's this? There's Chickasaw in here. The Abenaki remain. The Iroquois are all gone. Abenaki. I think, is that somebody? No, that's just part of Spanish California instead. Blackfoot are still here. And Arapo. But that's it in North America. All the Mexican ones gone as well. And actually South America, yeah, is completely gone. So that's quite sad. Brazil and Spain with quite a lot of territory. Denmark with the Falklands and South Georgia, or the South Sandwich Islands. I have no idea. Both names came up. I don't know. The province is South Georgia. The thing's called South Sandwich Islands. That's a great name, you know. Who doesn't want to be south of a sandwich? Right, here we go. Is there a new one? Yaka, Kasanji, Luba, Kazem, Congo, Lunda. I'll get that. This is pretty big, I guess. Let's have a look. Who's against who? I have no idea who's going to win this. Lunda seemed pretty strong compared to the rest. I think Portugal's just walking past. I don't think they're not involved. I think this should go probably, I don't know, there's 4 versus 2. I think there's one more, but I don't know where the other member is. They don't seem to be here. Oh no, it's 4v2. It is going in favour of the 4, but the 2 have Lunda, who is a lot bigger and a lot stronger, so that might change. If they separate peace some people, then things could get a little bit messy. I'm not really sure, but we'll see. I'm sure we'll find out pretty soon. Oh wow, the Ottomans, did they always have this? I think this is new. Maybe not, but they just gain some wasteland, if not, which is pretty good. Makes them look a lot bigger. How are we looking up here? Still the same, 8 for now. Austria has embraced the industrialization as a Spain, so Spain has definitely solidified first place for now. It's getting closer with the Mughals, actually. Qing is also slowly gaining on them. It's about 130 points between the three of them. But yeah, the Mughals, if they embrace this, would be right up there with Spain. Oh no, sorry, there's a Spain or 100 more. Sorry, I misread that. My mistake. 280 points. But Austria, yeah, with them getting it, that certainly will keep them on the list for longer. Probably would have fallen off eventually if someone else got it as well. But yeah, Austria, that will keep them as a great power for now. Obviously, Russia, I thought would have shot up with the adding of the Commonwealth's development, but I guess they have obviously the whole Enlightenment still to embrace. I guess they're just too big. But eventually, I'm sure they'll get that. Or they might have money issues. I don't know. I remember last game they had a lot of issues with their finances when I was playing. Oh, Fezzan. I don't know how they got their independence, but they did somehow. At one point they were owned by the Ottomans, but yeah, this should be a pretty quick victory, and that will see all their borders connected. So yeah, that should go down pretty quickly for the Ottomans. Poor Fezzan. The Ottomans are allied to Prussia. That's an interesting one. We'll see how that works out. It'd be cool if like they just helped Prussia get really strong, become a powerhouse themselves. I don't think that will happen. Theodoran separatists now, but yeah, Russia's starting to deal with them, although now there's noble rebels, so yeah, not Not a great time for Russia at the moment. We'll see how it goes. Qing is certainly making some progress here. I'm sure we'll get a peace deal pretty soon. They have 73 war score. We have another war between some of the minor nations of the HRE there. We can go have a look at in a second. But yeah, I think Qing should peace out of this pretty soon. Because bear in mind the west, yeah, there you go. The western side is wasteland. You can't actually go in it. And there you go. They grab this eastern territory pretty easily. So good job. Well done. You grab that. Alright, what's going on up here? Who is it in this war? I think, were you in it? Okay, I'm going to guess the team with Saxony is going to win. Again, no idea, but just hasn't in a guess. They're sort of the biggest, like it's 3v3 and Saxony is the biggest. So, going to give them the credit there. In fact, this should definitely be over by now, but I'm sure very soon it will be done. Yeah, there you go. They didn't take everything. That was nice, but they do now connect all their borders in a little snake. Still, we haven't seen Ottomans v Spain, although to be honest, Spain is so spread out over the whole globe, I don't think it'll matter. Ottoman revolutionaries, that's pretty big, 39 stack there, 40, 23, 42. I'm sure they can handle that, but that is pretty big. We'll see what sort of success they can have. At the moment, they don't have an heir. Could you imagine? I mean, this guy, 29. If Prussia, could you imagine Prussia just owning the Ottomans? And I imagine someone like Russia would be on the other side. Trying to prevent that secession. I mean, that would be, if someone gets the Ottomans as a vassal, that would be, or a personal union, that would be crazy. Not sure what exactly the future would hold. Right, Spain, oh, I think I jinxed it for some of those native tribes. Chickasaw and Abenaki could be in trouble here. Should be pretty quickly. Yeah, this will be an easy victory here for Florida? No, just Florida. Florida is French in this one. And then Abenaki. I mean, yeah, if Spain comes over here, again, they could win that. I doubt they'd conquer it. But, I mean, they could if they wanted to. And probably form, like, Spanish Canada or something out of the provinces. There's more than five, so you certainly could. I don't know if they could take all of it in one go, though. But, yeah, there's so many things. New Spain, obviously, being the biggest. Surprisingly enough, I thought French Louisiana would be more like development. Even the 13 colonies or Florida, but no, New Spain is just massive, I guess, so fair enough. Obviously, some of these northern ones, not so big, because a lot of this is wasteland for French Canada, Newfoundland, and not so much Pacifico Norte, but okay, yeah, a little bit of it is, and these provinces not worth as much. 58 war score. Okay, so I was wrong. This war is not going in Lunda's favour. We might see them divided up between the other four. That would be an interesting peace deal. If they just get ripped up and then you have a load of new countries around. Obviously, they've got to be careful. Portugal to the east is looking pretty big. Portuguese, Central Africa, and here's some more of Portugal. Spanish South Africa continues to grow. Okay, so these revolutionaries are certainly having some success. I mean, the Ottomans have enough troops to deal with them, but they aren't quite keen on attacking them just yet. So we'll see what happens. Maybe they want to have a revolution to avoid not having an heir. I mean, if you think about it tactically, it's not the worst decision in the world. I mean, it's not great, you know, to have the revolution, but I imagine revolutionary Ottomans. I don't think that will happen, like revolutionary Sweden. It'll probably be like a Portugal one where it just converts the government, but still. Moldavia and Wallachia are still owned by the Ottomans. They're the only vassals left. Russia struggling with rebels still. Don't know what France is up to. Still supporting the 13 colonies' independence, although that hasn't happened. Portugal, no, they don't have an heir though as well, another one. Their leader's a lot older than the Ottoman leader, so they could end up with Portugal being owned by Luango. That could occur. I doubt they know. I don't know. Spain will surely, or France or someone will step in, but that'd be pretty cool for them. Luango here, that would be kind of cool. I don't think it will happen, but fetishist zealots have taken over for now. This is a very weird, it should be divided like between the four. Yeah, we'll see what happens now. They should get separate pieced, which will not be so good. Congo and Lunda certainly lost here. See what sort of peace deal we get. They've all just like started going, is this not done yet? Am I missing something? And they're all just chasing each other around in a circle. Surely this is getting soon. 98 war score. Yeah, there you go. And Lunda does shrink. The Yaka and Kasanji definitely grew the most out of that. But there you go. Not so good. And Congo is still... And there you go. Kasanji and Yaka take the three provinces between them and eliminate the Congo from the game. But there you go. That's a pretty good victory for these four. I'm sure they'll pick off Lunda slowly in the future. Who was it that did really well in the last game? It wasn't one of these, was it? There was one that just, like, conquered all this middle area, got all the wasteland, and they just looked giant. I don't think it was one of these four or five. I think it was somebody else. But it was still pretty... I think it was... Was it Kong? Congo? No, Kong's here. It wasn't Kong. It was someone like Congo, but it wasn't Congo. They had a similar name, I think. I can't remember. The Ottoman revolutionaries are certainly being left to their own devices for now. The Ottomans are rebuilding, but I don't know why. They could probably just take these out. I don't know what they're doing. They are playing it risky. The Ottomans do not have an heir. Apparently, how have they got to 10 years old so quick? They didn't have one year ago, but now they have a 10-year-old one. What? Where the... Pulled that rabbit out of a hat. There you go. Portugal, there you go. They have age zero, but still, they also get one. Catastrophes averted. Is there any other big countries without an heir? Britain doesn't have heirs. Austria, no, Austria's got one. Sweden have elections as well. Not for next year, actually, for them. Oh, they own Denmark. I did not know that, but there you go. Denmark is a vassal of revolutionary Sweden. England, by the way, is still not integrated Scotland. I don't know if they want to form Great Britain. Maybe they're not interested, but they haven't done that yet. Are they allied to Qing? They are, okay. There are some interesting alliances. There's that Russian-France one, obviously on top of Russia and Spain already. Yeah, England, Austria, and Qing. This is certainly setting the stage. I feel like you've got two teams almost, although Russia and France has now come to an end. That did not last particularly long. I don't know what happened there, but yeah, that one's ended. But still, Russia has Austria and Spain. Qing now has England, and it always at war with Japan again. That's not good for Japan. Qing calling in Tonkin and Kam. Yeah, that's the big one here. Oh, what? Yaka? Oh, Yaka, how have you managed that? You literally only just got out of... they got too big for their boots here. They got out of their war and then attacked Lunda and Luba again. And Luango. So yeah, this might end badly for Yaka. Don't know what they for. You're finally doing good. Just mess it up straight away. We'll see what happens here. I think naval strength is important. Obviously, I expect Qing to be 180,000. That has dropped, and the others have caught up a little bit. But still, and I don't know where Japan is likely to be. Sort of down here, 30,000, nothing special. Total boats, yeah, Qing. Qing is first. Japan is not even on this list. At the top, like Antilles has more. That's not a good sign. Japan 33. So yeah, Qing should be able to land troops in the Japanese islands should they want to. They're gonna have full naval control. So yeah, this could get pretty bad for Japan. Not what they would have wanted. Qing continuing to add development as they try to hunt down the Spanish in first place. The same for the Mughals. Still, no one's embraced that other institution. Just Austria and Spain. Sure, someone else will get there eventually. Get it done. Russia's still dealing with plenty of separatists. None of them, they all seem to just have like one bit of land. None of them seem to have lots of bits. And the Ottomans still having some revolutionaries. And sorry if you heard that noise. My Xbox just turned on from thin air. We must have a ghost in the room. Must have breathed too hard near it or something. I don't know. I did not turn it on. That would have scared the living daylights out of me if that happened at night time. So at least it's morning and the light is out. There you go, you can hear the noise again. Yeah, I don't know what happened there. That's random. Turned on. I didn't even go near it. Like, sometimes if I move my hand near it, it senses it. But yeah, that was weird. There you go. Haunted. Haunted episode. We'll put that in the title. Get some clickbait. Haunted EU4 episode. Whoa, these guys, I swear they were like pink a minute ago. Am I losing my mind? I don't know. I feel like the whole game is actually darker, but that's just because it's November. They are all with France now anyway, so this should not be Not be too fun for them. There won't be many tribes left. The Chickasaw are gone. Oh, the Comanche is still here. How did I not see them? I don't know. They are still here. Maybe that's why I got confused. Oh, but Arapaho is gone. Blackfoot survives again. But there you go. Yeah, Arapaho goes. French Louisiana. Continue to grow. Spanish Greenland. Was that always Spanish Greenland? That's interesting. I don't know if it was always like that. Yeah, Qing has landed in southern Japan. So this should now... And they're going to make the crossing, so this should be a pretty quick victory from this point forward as they just land more and more troops over. Not really what you want if you're Japan. Qing, anything else? Some of these wars have been going on for a while. This Ethiopian war, for example. Yaka is actually winning. That is, you guys are going to come out on top here then. That's great. Yeah, I don't know what's going on here. Ethiopia and Darfur against Hadramut, Aden, and Ajuran. Ethiopia certainly succeeding, I would say. Oh no, sorry, losing. Never mind, I got that completely wrong. Yeah, looks like it's going in Ajuran's favor, but there are some rebels just where would we be without rebels? Just mixing everything up, making it all nice and confusing. These Ottoman revolutionaries, I mean, they must be getting close to their demands. I don't know, but they're certainly doing a lot of work. Maybe there's a chance. Small chance that they do something. Probably not. England drops below Austria for the first time in a while, and that is due to obviously that low percentage, that modifier. So they do drop below into 8th place. Again, I don't think they'll drop out of 8th. The only real chance is maybe if New Spain declares independence again, and even then it's only briefly while New Spain is independent. Of course, that would knock Spain off top spot if it was to happen again. But yeah, not really much at the moment. And Qing is the big war, 19 war score against Japan. See how that plays out for them. France is the interesting one. I think this middle pack, that's interesting. Who's going to finish where out of like the Ottomans? Actually, sorry, not the Ottomans. They're in a clear fourth now. But France and Russia is probably the most interesting one to compare. And this top three could get quite interesting by the end. There's only 20 odd years to go, 28 years in game. Qing certainly having some success, and yeah, we will be doing a let's play again afterwards. I'll probably be having a go as France with all their new weird start where they have a ton of vassals instead of just owning everything. So yeah, we'll be playing as the big blue blob, getting to do some cool stuff, trying to make France look like France, and I don't know, just control Europe. I don't know, obviously we just did it as Austria, so we'll see. But yeah, obviously France, it will be a bit more about going and exploring the world, doing this sort of stuff. I don't even know what we're going to do, but we'll do something. Culture map mode. How's it looking? Castilian, still pretty dominant. Portuguese, Brazilian. Brazilian is definitely growing. Bit of Dutch. Yeah, but mostly Castilian in the New World. And then as you get further north, you have more English and French, and it's a lot more messy. Borders, yeah, there's a lot of cultural sort of borders. There's still some tribal areas as well. Iroquois, Creek. Mexican is nowhere near Mexico, but... I'll get fairly near, but not in Mexico. It has spread, I guess, from Mexico. English, Scottish. Yeah, around here it's not changed as much. Qing making slow progress. I thought they'd be going quicker than this, but I mean, they're maybe only just sending some of their troops. They did just win a big battle, though, so going well. Prussia's still losing in West Africa. This is getting a bit embarrassing for them. And, oh no, Yaka, it was looking so good for you, but it has got backfired horribly. There was a brief moment it was looking good for them, but yeah, I think they will now be destroyed. And Lunda will probably recover some of what they lost previously, which is good news for them. Not so good news for Yaka. Still Ottoman revolutionary, still Russia with a lot of rebels. Come on, guys, they should have the power to deal with them, though. It's getting a bit embarrassing. Come on, you can deal with these. It's not too difficult. Oh, they just dealt with some of them. There's still 40 stacks just roaming around. If this 50 stack sieges out Constantinople, you might have some issues. That would not be good. And it's getting there. Still pretty low. Yeah, it's not going to happen just yet. There's still 0% chance of a surrender. But once this gets above zero, maybe they'll have a chance. slow progress. But yeah, I mean, normally your armies are stronger than the rebels, so I'm a bit surprised they're so fearful of them. We'll see, are they going to fight them here? No, they're just moving around, very cautious of how they deal with these guys. So maybe they want a revolution, you never know. Maybe they've planned this all out. Maybe it was all planned, they want to have one anyway. Just want to make it seem like there's a revolution going on, but they wanted one anyway. But that will be it for this episode. So as always, if you have enjoyed, please do be sure to leave a like and a comment down below. If you haven't already, it would also be amazing if you could subscribe to the channel. Try and get us to 1,500 subscribers. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.